The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment, heard on the official website of HEW Entertainment. It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
The Beast! The Man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 372928. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 372928. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio, on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Play the fucking track! Play that fucking track!
Oh, there it is.
Limp Bizkit! DMX! Redman!
That's right, yo!
Urban Man! We just keep on rolling, baby! Are you ready?
Rolling, 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 r
with slang atrocious. When I let these nuts hang, focus, it's Wu-Tang. What the fuck's a hoodie and the bluffin'? I wave my black flag at the roaches who approaches these twin super soakers who have poisonous darts for coping. Too late to get your blowgun unhosted. Your left butted up and lightly toasted. So what? I drink and smoke too much. So what? I cuss too much.
Shut the fuck up. Now when we roll, you motherfuckers tucking your gold. Cause for the platinum, I'm jacking niggas up in limos. It ain't nothing for bullets to unbutton your clothes. Description, yellow mail, tissue up in his nose. You bitches, swing the vine on the baboon nuts. I'm hairy as hell, out of hell and tattooed up. I'm a dog only, fuck in the bathroom. What? In high school I dealt only with the classroom sluts.
My name is Johnny Donnie, brass mask, tuck the gap, yeah, cut your cash flow, yell if you want money. Funny, a hungry dummy snatch crumb from me, dock and hot, mix bodies in the mosh
pit. And I'm the D.O., you looking at the raw invented. On Friday, I spit 35 to 40 minutes. Smell up the bathroom like Craig Paul was in it. Ending up on your back, roofs, wars, and billet. Anyone can match me, I crack them all to Guinness. Fuck how many thugs, the players, and ballers in it. Brick City, Shaolin, better call the sinners. Boys that'll run up in your white mall is
who shoots to make it spark. Now I'm a fair nigga, but ain't dead nigga quicker than the hair trigger. So if you dead nigga, it'll be like your man trying to hold your brain to your head. But you'll be shitting on yourself cause you already dead. And at the funeral you won't need a casket. I'm leaving just enough of them to stuff in a basket. Let's just get the task hit. Never really need my ass kicked. My mom's never let me forget that I'm a bastard. I ain't never been shit, that ain't gonna be shit. That's why I take shit whenever I see shit. It's just that deep shit. Be short but do what I wanna do, and that's what I'm gonna do right here in front of you. And I'll be running you and your man straight up out. Yeah, niggas ain't running a fucking thing but your mouth.
It is platinum thing right here, but we're doing it all the time. You better get some better beats and get some better rhymes.
We really, really, really wanna get shit started. With people everywhere, just get free started.
Wow, over 1,000 episodes of Monday Night Raw, in the words of WWE Chairman Mr. McMahon, astonishing, thrilling, incredible, spectacular, amazing, some of the words I can use to define what the 1,000th edition of Raw 1,000, represented just a couple of nights ago. It was an awesome show, and we invite you to join the conversation on our Facebook page on facebook.com/HEW Entertainment and tell us what you think by liking and commenting on our video blog for the 1,000th edition of Raw. We also invite you to send us a tweet on our Twitter page where you can follow the show at twitter.com/JonathanClark1, and you can subscribe to our YouTube channel and leave us a few comments on the 1,000th edition of Raw at youtube.com/JonathanClark22. It saw a wedding, it saw several championship matches, it saw the reunions of DX and the Brothers of Destruction, everything, but no Stone Cold Steve Austin. Someone explain to me where Stone Cold Steve Austin is, what his whereabouts are, what is his explanation for not being a part of the 1,000th edition of Raw that even saw an appearance of The Undertaker for the first time since WrestleMania 28, and upping his record at WrestleMania from 19-0 to 20-0. There is a DVD and Blu-ray release now on the 20-year streak of The Undertaker. It's called WWE Undertaker The Streak, which is available everywhere now. It was a fantastic way to promote the streak by having The Undertaker there and to promote the history of the Brothers of Destruction. But with even an Undertaker appearance there on the 1,000th edition of Raw, you would think we would open the 1,000th edition of Raw with a Stone Cold Steve Austin, Mr. McMahon confrontation inside of the ring, which the end result of would have been a stunner from Austin to McMahon to commemorate the history of the Austin-McMahon feud, which had DVDs, documentaries made of it, and a video package that aired on the 1,000th edition of Raw, where several new talent superstars, including John Cena, believed that if it had not have been for the feud of Austin and McMahon, the Monday Night Wars would have never been won by WWE, and we'd be watching Nitro now for 3 hours. And I believe, for one, WCW would have won the war if it hadn't been for the feud of Austin and McMahon, because I think that that really catapulted the Attitude Era, which was started on August 11th, 1997, by Generation X, the original DX, Shawn Michaels, Triple H, Rick Rude, and China. You know, that really catapulted the Attitude Era into a completely different direction. And with all the video packages and emphasis on the Austin McMahon feud, which had a lot of highlights of Monday Night Raw memories given to it, leading up to the 1,000th edition Raw, which took place on the 23rd of July, just a couple of days ago, you would think Austin would be there. So why wasn't he there? Is there a reasonable explanation as to why Austin turned down to have anything to do with the 1,000th edition of Raw? We saw so many appearances from Vader to The Rock, to Trish Stratus, to The Undertaker, and no Stone Cold Steve Austin. It really let me down. You know, DX, it would have been more effectively done if they would have had Degeneration X be involved with the whole Brock Lesnar-Triple H SummerSlam match that Brock Lesnar accepted on the 1,000th edition of Raw, a brawling